work back there.
What is the church without technical difficulties?
Or
you might never know. All right, as we prepare to come to the table of our Lord, let us go to God in prayer. God, we thank you that the reason that we have been called to pour out our love onto you and to the world is because you first poured out your love on us. And this is nowhere more evident than it is in the Lord's Supper. When we come together at the communion table, we remember that great gift of grace that you have given, not only to us, but to all of creation. So Lord, we lift up praises to you. We thank you that on the night that you were betrayed, at that Passover dinner, you took the bread of the Passover meal. You gave thanks for it, and you broke it, and you gave it to your disciples, and you said, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you." Later, you took the cup. After giving thanks for it, you gave it to them, and you said, "Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood, the new covenant poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you do it in remembrance of me." Lord, we remember these mighty and holy acts. And we lift up our praise and thanksgiving to a God who would give everything for us. As we eat the bread, as we drink the juice, help us to encounter you somehow, mysteriously a part of this meal. That God, we might encounter again your grace. That we might participate again in your salvation. And that we might share it with the world. On this we pray in your name, Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord, who taught us to pray by saying,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen."
Body of Christ, broken for you. The blood of Christ, poured out for you. Just a couple of reminders. First of all, we'll be serving two different ways. You can either take a piece of bread and dip it into the juice and take both elements together, or you can take a piece of bread, eat it, and take one of the small cups of grape juice and drink it separately. Either way is just as holy as the other, so do whichever one you feel called to do. We also do have a gluten-free option. Just let me know before I give you a piece of the Hawaiian bread, okay? Also want to remind you that though this table is in a United Methodist church, it's by no means a United Methodist table. This is Christ's holy table, and all are welcome to Christ's holy table. You don't have to be a member of this church. You don't have to be United Methodist. You don't even have to be a Christian. For we firmly believe and we celebrate that everything that needed to be done in this meal was done a long time ago. We just get to receive. And what a wonderful means of grace this is. So any who want to experience God's love for the first time or for the millionth time, you are welcome at this table. Please come as you feel led.
Thank you.
everyone received?
No.
Not until every knee has bowed down and every tongue has confessed that Jesus Christ is Lord will everyone have received the body and blood. That means we still have work to do. That means we still have people who need to hear the great news of the gospel. So may we use this encounter at the table as a way to recharge, as a way to recenter, and as a way to send us out into the world so that everyone might one day know, that everyone might one day receive. Amen.